Welcome to Live at Studio 16. I'm your host, Noel Rhodes. Thank you for joining us. And why would you want to go and do a thing like that? Because Voom is here, and they bring with them sounds to be found only in the sonic dream world they create. Peek inside their laboratory, partake of their potion. Time to start stillness, audio stop motion. No one knows their reasons or from whence they come. Join them now, live at Studio 16. It's time for Voom.
Witches who give gifts, the turning of black tea to gold. I knew a prince and he walked with the misfits through moan. The longer the road and the deeper the garden she showed. Carefully long hair. Get along here, we've got a long way to go. We get along here, we've got a long way to go. Mystery gives us permission to seek what we hide. Tongues that clash but extend invitation inside. This little whisper conducts a momentum of sight. Loosen the jackals and tell them we're waiting outside. Loosen the jackals and tell them we're waiting outside. Loosen the jackals. Jackals, tell them waiting outside.
just these old instruments that you've somehow. These are the ones that you collected. Yeah.
Really interested in analog equipment and synthesizers and tape delays and mechanical effects and I don't know.
Finding the balance.
Yeah.
A lot of the music were influenced by like 1960s psych and progressive music and some, you know, early 70s no wave and minimalist ventures, so we kind of like to merge all of those things, but part of it is having the really tangible gear that really
The physical stuff.
It would probably be easier to just bring a laptop and set up a laptop and all these things loop together, but I never really cared for that in live performance. I like there to be something actually happening and being done in the space.
Thank you.
Big music fans and have pretty eclectic, diverse record collections that kind of cover everything.
And record, I heard you say record collections, definitely yes, vinyl.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and I see your releases are available on vinyl if you can get them. I know I saw one you said was sold out from, because people that love your kind of music, I think, are going to be attracted to the whole vinyl aspect, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think that it's the same thing that interests us in some of the instruments we have is what interests us in the vinyl as well. In the analog sound, there's a continuous gradient as opposed to an incremental gradient in digital technologies. In digital technology, the distance between 0 and 1 is one step, but in analog, the distance between 0 and 1 is an infinite spectrum. So rather than compress nature into this stepwise reproduction, if we can make sound using analog tools and then produce it via analog output devices.
But we're not 100% peers. I think also our love of vinyl comes from wanting something tangible. Mm-hmm. Again, it's having that disc in your hand and having this beautiful album artwork. So we did start our own small press vinyl label, Secret Lodge, so that we could put our albums out on vinyl. That was, for me, 99% the point of making music, is so that I could have this product, this tangible thing in the end that I could, you know, put on my record player and hear.
Thank you.
You guys seem to be natural for your music to go with visuals, either whether it's, you know, a TV show or a movie, or that's something that I'm sure you guys are doing, right?
A little bit.
Yeah.
We've done a little bit of that. We've never actually made a score for anything in particular.
But it's something we really like to do. Yeah. People keep saying that, like, this is cinematic, or you should do this or that. So I think that that's something that could be down the road for us, and that's something that would be really interesting.
Yeah,
it make
maybe
sense.
It's the speed of the music. Sometimes we don't do very much for a while.
Maybe by cinematic they mean slow.
Well, evocative is a word. I think that, you know, it really, like, you know, it takes your mind on a trip when you're in there. When they hear your sound, they call it L.A. Noir, right?
And I have heard that, and I do like the use of that term. I think that it kind of calls back to the, you know, old noir film, and there's a lot of great history in Los Angeles that gets, you know, can be overlooked, but there are good things about this place.
Goodbye.
Bye.